What's up, guys? So in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at this, a 9-year-old MacBook, and seeing how well it does in games. So what we have here is a 13-inch mid-2009 MacBook Pro with a 2.26 GHz Intel Core 2 Duo, 4 GB of 1333 MHz DDR3 RAM, and our graphics controller is an NVIDIA GeForce 9400M with 256 MB of VRAM. Now, these are of course not going to be stellar specs, especially by today's standards, but we have a few games that I think might just be able to scrape by on a machine such as this. So before we get started, there's only a couple of games that we can even really attempt to run. So one of the ones that I wanted to try to run for you guys is Fortnite, because it's a very popular game. However, this is a 2009 MacBook, which means the most recent supported software you can run is OS X 10.11, which is what I'm personally running on this machine. Now, there is a very easy patcher that'll allow you to run Sierra and later. However, in my experience, I did have that patch running on this computer. It was really slow for day-to-day things. Your experience will vary depending on the model that you have. More powerful 15-inch models that are unsupported tend to run better, but from my experience, the patcher was making the computer pretty slow, so I went back to 10.11. And because this is running 10.11, we can't run Fortnite because it was crashing and it won't even launch. So, let's jump into all of the other games except for Fortnite, because that won't run. Alright, so here we are on the MacBook. As I mentioned before, Fortnite is not supported on this particular operating system, and it really won't even launch. It just fails over and over again, as you can see. So, we're gonna go ahead and just jump straight into CSGO. I would like to play Fortnite, but it's not worth it to run Sierra on this computer for me, because this is the base model 2009, and Sierra was really slowing it down, so I'm sticking with El Capitan. Now, we haven't even gotten into the game yet, and already I'm feeling it heating up a little bit. But before we jump in, let's go ahead and make sure all of these settings are turned down to minimum and disabled, so we have absolutely the bottom of the bottom of specifications for this thing. Alright, so here we are in the game, and the frame rate is pretty bad. So I've had to turn off multi-core rendering and VSync to get more consistently high frames, because it was just running around 7 or 8 with those things on. But as such, we are getting some pretty big lag spikes. We are also getting some noticeable screen tearing. There's a lot of input lag, so I don't know if this is coming across on camera, but when I move my mouse, it's like a half second delay when stuff actually starts to happen. So it's really quite difficult to play. Ooh, oh, hello. Alrighty. Whoa, let's get out of there. Alright, and now we have Portal. So, when I did the video on the MacBook, the 12-inch MacBook, I tried Portal 2 because I thought we might be able to get away with it. It didn't run so well, so that thing could probably run Portal pretty easily. It's an older game at this point. I say older, it's from like 2006 or something. So yeah, it's definitely an old game at this point. Now, theoretically, we should be able to run this game on this computer, because the game is older than the computer, so hopefully we'll be able to use it. Start here. So I've already set this to the lowest possible settings to see what can happen. So that's interesting. It looks like we're getting some pretty inconsistent frames. Like, it's actually like if I just go like this, we're probably getting about 50-60 FPS. It's actually kind of steadying out. There's like some pretty serious spikes that you can probably see. So maybe if we turn on frame smoothing, we'll be able to fix that. Alright, so we have vertical sync. I'm going to turn on multi-core rendering just to see if we can do something with that. Well, hot damn. That is totally playable. So at this point, it looks like we are running a pretty consistent 50, 60 FPS. It's dropping every once in a while, but it's not horrible. But honestly, I'm pretty surprised. I was not expecting it to run this well. Now, granted, we are just in this one room. I'm thinking that it's probably not something that you're gonna wanna play for a long period of time. And I'm noticing that same issue with the input lag. It's a little bit annoying. Part of that, I think, is due to macOS not being the best for gaming anyway. But I'm surprised. It looks like CSGO is definitely not playable, but Portal, certainly gonna be playable. Alright, so now I'm going to be trying out Civ 5. This is gonna be a little tricky because this game is pretty easy on graphics cards, but it's pretty heavy on CPU power. So I'm not sure how it's going to handle this computer. Alright, so we're just gonna launch right into a standard setup game, and we're gonna see what we end up with. I haven't changed any settings, it's all what is automatically applied. So it looks like it's actually running at native resolution, so we'll see if that is even possible. My guess would be no. However, a game such as this, you know, you don't necessarily need 60 FPS all the time. I used to play this game on my late 2011 MacBook Pro, unibody 13-inch, just like this one, except this is older, obviously. And, you know, it was running about 20 FPS, but it wasn't the worst experience in the world. And in fact, this is pretty bad. I mean, we'll try it, but honestly, a game such as this, you can kind of suffer through with low settings. So, you know, it's obviously not a fantastic gaming experience, but it is running. And it's running about 10 FPS. You can see the map is loading in pretty slowly. That's gonna be due to this old Core 2 Duo. Can't really handle this type of workload. I would say Civ 5 may be playable. If you have nothing else to do and you're stuck with this computer alone and you've got a charger, you know, you could get away with playing this for a while. Same with Portal. You could get away with playing Portal. Portal was in the 40s, 50s as far as frame rate, so that's pretty solid. CSGO is definitely a no. That's a game where you really need high FPS, and you're not going to get it from this computer, so I would stay away from CSGO if you're going to play on something like this. But the other two games, I'm very surprised. I'm very happy. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you found it useful. If you have one of these and you have other games that you have found to be playable or that you enjoy playing on this computer, let me know in the comments section below. And oh my goodness, I don't want to go to war. And as usual, I encourage you to head over to my subreddit. We have a lot of great discussions going on. The link is in the description. And I will catch you guys in the next video.